This is the Friday edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.
Good evening. I'm Melanie Chartoff, and these are tonight's top stories. Vowing to make this the best and easiest presidential transition in history, President Carter is spending a quiet weekend in the country with Nancy Reagan. Not to be outdone, President-elect Reagan and Rosalind Carter phoned Jimmy and Nancy from their private room at Plato's Retreat to say what fun they were having. President Jimmy Carter was criticized this week by members of his own party for giving his concession speech before all the polls had even closed. White House aides said that Carter originally wanted to give his speech at 7:25 in the morning, 25 minutes after the polls opened, but they talked him into waiting until later so that only the people living in California would feel screwed out of their vote. In other campaign news, Senator Warren Magnuson of Washington was defeated this week after 44 years in the House and Senate. When asked what his plans for the future were, the senator said he would travel with his wife to her planet for a short vacation. Vanessa Redgrave said in Lebanon this week that she would pledge to the death her support of the Palestinian Liberation Organization in their fight to overthrow the state of Israel. Miss Redgrave added that she was not anti-Semitic, and to show her good faith, she offered her apartment in London as a new homeland for the Jews. Well, the terms of the Jerry Lewis divorce settlement were disclosed today. Mrs. Patty Lewis will receive $12 million, all in change. Is crime in the streets getting somewhat out of hand? That is the subject of tonight's Friday Focus, and for that report, we take you now to East Los Angeles and our correspondent, Maryedith Burrell.
You're looking at a classic scene. An innocent citizen parking in a strange section of town decides to leave his car unattended, only for a few minutes. But from out of nowhere, a group of experienced automobile strippers appears. This film, when speeded up, shows their operation in progress. The crime is quick, efficient, and professional. All saleable parts are stripped from the body and loaded into a nearby van. The theft is so sudden, so unexpected, that even the victims themselves don't know what happened.
But astonishingly enough, accounts of car strippings have dropped off in recent weeks due to a police crackdown on the sale of stolen automobile parts. Also, modern built-in security systems are offered in many new cars, which tend to deter break-in. So how have the car stripping thugs survived? By simply finding an alternate target for their crime. People.
This time-lapse photography shows that this new breed of criminal known as the body stripper is just as quick and professional as before. Within seconds, their evil deed is done, and the victim doesn't even know what hit him.
Assembly plant where rumored stolen apparel parts are reassembled and sold. With more and more used clothing stores opening up, authorities are slow to make indictments stating there is no proof. Well, let's take a look at this shirt. Look closely. The label has been sanded out. We talked to Felix Schaefer, owner of a used clothing store.
Hey, we don't talk to nobody.
So far, the police have been unsuccessful in apprehending the body strippers in action. It's easy to understand why. They attack without warning, work with lightning speed, and leave their unfortunate victim helpless without any trace. We talked anonymously with an ex-body stripper by the name of Bruno Weiss.
You got it right, bro. I was one mean dude for ripping people off like that. Sure, but I came from a tough background, you know what I mean?
We decided to take our cameras close up to get a first-hand secret glimpse of the body strippers in action. This astonishing footage was shot with an extreme wide-angle lens on an early Saturday morning in October.
Good! Beautiful! Hey, wait!
this. Following this week's election, the presidency and the Senate now belong to conservatives. And one of the contributing factors in their victory was the influence of fundamentalist religious groups, particularly the Moral Majority led by evangelist Jerry Falwell. Although some are concerned about the effect of these groups on the political process, we on the Friday edition feel that there is no cause for undue alarm. This is not the first time that the church has injected itself into politics. Why, just look at the Spanish Inquisition, the Salem witch hunts, and the takeover of the Iranian government by fanatical Muslims. Now, doesn't that make you feel just a bit better? I'm Melanie Chartoff. Have a good weekend.
This has been the Friday edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.